When you're first starting your web design and SEO business, one of the biggest hurdles to get past is your portfolio. After all, you want to get clients, but if you don't have a portfolio, that's hard to do. But it's also hard to build a portfolio if you don't have clients. So what do you do? How do you handle this? So here I'd like to talk about 5 different ways that you can go about building your portfolio before you get your first client. The first option is to create fake work. Now, there is no rule out there that everything in your portfolio has to be for an actual real paying client. The purpose of a portfolio is to demonstrate your abilities. So we're not talking about going out and copying somebody else's designs and putting it on your site or presenting work that is not actually your own. But when you don't have work, you can create images, or you can even take it a step further and create an actual working website to post on your website. This way, clients are going to be able to see your actual abilities and know that you're going to be able to get the job done. Now, another thing that you can do here to take this a step farther is you can go out there and you can find a business that is in the niche that you want to serve, that needs a redesign or needs help with their marketing. And let's say you're offering web design. What you can do is you can take their website and you can redesign it. And then now what you'll have is a case study. You can demonstrate to potential clients how you had an old website, now you have a new website, and show them how you designed that and why you designed the site the way that you did to help a business achieve its goals. So then they're going to be able to see how you can take a website from A to B. Now, what you can also do is then take this design and go back to that business and present your design and see what they think and see if they would be interested in working with you. They say no, that's okay. You have a portfolio example, but you can always take that same design, swap out the logo for another company, and present it to company B or company C until you have someone who is interested as well. Now, another option that you have is to work for free. Now, there's a lot of debate out there. Some people say you should work for free to get started. Other people say never offer any of your services for free. So I'm going to give you some thoughts on this. The biggest thing is, if you choose to do this, make sure that the free work that you are doing is going to pay off for you. So that means once you know who your ideal client is, who you actually want to serve, only do free work within that target market. So if you are working with plumbers, for example, don't do free work for a dog trainer that is going to do nothing to build your portfolio or to help you land those plumbing clients. Now, another thing that you could do, for example, if you are offering SEO services, is you can offer to do smaller services for free. So this could be something like ranking a long tail keyword or ranking in the local pack. So you're just building up some citations for a business, or working to rank a video for a low competition keyword. So you see, these are some things that you can do relatively quickly and easily, and it really is going to help build trust with these companies. And oftentimes those companies are going to turn out to be paying customers because you built that trust, and more importantly, you showed them results. But in the meantime, regardless, you are building your portfolio, so you have some results to show. Now, a third option is that you can offer your services at a discount. And what you can do is actually approach potential businesses in your niche, in your industry, and you can let them know that you are working on building a portfolio with businesses just like theirs. And what you would like to offer them is a discount on your services so that you can further build your portfolio. Now, just as with any client, you always want to make sure that you are showing the value that you can provide and make it really a no-brainer for them. But this is going to allow you to still get paid, and it's going to be a win for them because they get the services for a lower price. Now, keep in mind that when I say lower price, this does not mean that you have to do a $1,000, $2,000 service for $100. You can really think about that, and you can offer, let's say, a $1,500 package for maybe $750, or a $1,000 package for $500. So think about that. You don't have to use those numbers. I'm just throwing those out there, but that is another way that you can build up some clients. Now, another thing that you can do is think about your portfolio and what else can be added in. So this could be presentations that you have done, that you've put together. This could be awards. This could be previous experience. This could be links to places where you have written blog posts, certificates that you have, somewhere that you have submitted your work and it's actually been shown on another site. So think about some other things that you can use in your portfolio to build up that trust and even show a little bit of variety as well. Now, the fifth option that you have is to barter. So let's say that you are, again, working with plumbing companies and you are in need of some plumbing services. You can also work out a way to barter where they give you some services in exchange for your services. Let's say that you are serving landscaping companies and you could benefit from those services. Then you can work out an exchange where they provide you their services and in exchange you provide your services to them. So that can work out really nicely. Both companies are getting what they need. They need those services, and at the same time, you're building your portfolio. So there you have it. Those are the five options. You can create fake work. You can work for free, work for a discount, focus on what else you can include, and barter your services. Now, before I let you go, a few things that I want you to keep in mind. First, take your portfolio very seriously. Quality over quantity, okay? Your client can only expect for their project to be as good as the worst example in your portfolio, okay? So don't ever put anything that's just okay or isn't your favorite work or something that really shows what you can do. So I'd rather see less examples in your portfolio than a lot of examples, and some of them are just okay examples. So always put your best work out there, even if that means showing fewer examples. And more importantly, set a deadline. Set a deadline. Know when you are going to have this work done by. What happens is we can get very paralyzed in this stage. We don't actually take the action and start building our portfolio. We worry more about what portfolio example we're going to have or how we're going to add a portfolio example that we don't actually do the work. So set a date for it to be done by. That way you get that momentum going. And once you get one done, the second one is going to flow right behind it. It starts going much faster. That way you can move on with your business and start actually getting real paying clients in. You can always continue to build your portfolio as you grow.